The information that I'm about to share is not available in magazine, newspaper, on TV, or even in some diet books. Unfortunately, even if you have a personal trainer, there's a great likelihood that they wouldn't be clear on this either. And that is why I'm going to give you correct information, which is based on scientific research. However, I'm going to make it easier for you to understand. So let's have a quick look as to how your body manages the fat that is stored and the fat that is burned up for energy. As you plan your diet, you fit in a few meals and a few snacks. Let's say some cereal toast in the morning, a sandwich at lunchtime, and some rice or pasta at dinner. In between, you might have some fruits, a chocolate, ice cream, or perhaps a cup of coffee. All those foods have certain kinds of macronutrients in them called carbohydrates. Foods can be made up of carbohydrate, proteins, and fat. Different foods have different amount of each. So meat, for example, is all protein and fat. Bread is largely carbohydrate, some protein, and barely any fat. Carbohydrates, when consumed, are broken down into simplest form of sugar in the bloodstream, which is called glucose. This is then used by the body for energy. The level of glucose in the blood needs to be balanced quite delicately between a certain range. If there is too much or too little, then things can become very dangerous or even deadly. Hence, your body has developed a very smart mechanism of storing away any excess glucose when there is too much, and it does so by sending insulin around the blood. It tells the muscles and the fat cells that they should absorb glucose from blood. The body continues to do this until glucose is at a safe amount. The absorbed glucose is utilized by the muscle cells immediately or is stored for later use. Glucose is absorbed by the fat cells where it combines with fatty acids and stored for later use. Muscles have a limited storage capacity. So if there is a lot of extra glucose, then most of it inevitably goes into your fat cells. If you do not eat for a longer period of time, perhaps a few hours, then there is little or no insulin into your blood and the fat cells is ready to release the extra energy stored back in the bloodstream. This can only happen in the absence of insulin. The science behind this is that if there is insulin, then there is already too much glucose in the blood and thus the fat cells would not be allowed to be released. So, in the absence of insulin, fat cells can release their energy into the bloodstream for you to use. If you eat another meal or a snack with some carbohydrate, then to show some more insulin will be released, so your body can balance blood sugar level again. For most of us, this process of repeated occurrence daily, and that is why some diet recommends eating 5 to 6 times a day, so as to ensure the blood sugar levels are even. But that does not explain as to why we gain fat and how we can burn it up again. Over years of eating meals and snack and releasing insulin, the muscle cells and the fat cells tend to get deaf to insulin's message. And the bigger the snacks have been, the bigger is the effect. Now this indicates that the body needs to release more insulin so that the muscles and the fat cells do what they need to do. And therefore the period of time when insulin is not present tend to get shorter and shorter. Or in fact, the only time when insulin is not present is overnight. Now you might be wondering, what about those muscle cells? They use glucose for energy. And that's right. They use energy to move you around all day long. However, the key to muscle cells is that they're incredibly efficient. And for many people, the muscle cells may be full of energy that does not get completely used up during the day. And that means that you do not need a lot of additional energy. If your exercise regime is so vigorous that the muscle cells are depleted of the energy reserves, then there's a lot of energy that it can accommodate. And this is a very healthy situation for your body because they can store more glucose in the muscle cells as compared to your fat cells. With insulin being key to fat storage and fat burning, it makes sense that a weight loss method that works and the one that continues to work into the future needs to minimize the carbohydrate intake and thus decreases the level of insulin. This will help you burn your own fat for energy and not store any additional fat. If you have any queries or concern, please feel free to add a comment and I'll respond to you as soon as I can. If you find the information helpful, please do not forget to like, comment and subscribe. I'll see you in my next video.